Hi everyone, welcome to the Curious World of Alice. When you see this fruit at the grocery store, what does it indicate? That's right, it's summertime. Unlike other melons, the watermelon stops ripening at the time of harvest. That means even if you keep it on the counter for longer, it will not positively impact its yumminess. That puts a lot of pressure on picking the right one. Maybe remotely comparable to picking the right life partner, because you end up being stuck with it. I'll share a few tips on the selection process and how to efficiently cut it. Stay tuned. You want the shape to be relatively smooth without any bumps. Pick up the watermelon to assess its weight. You want it to be dense. That means for similar sizes, you want to pick the heavier one. The riper it is, the more yellow this becomes. So if you see one that is white or not as yellow, so more pale, that means it was harvested when it was less ripe. You want the watermelon to be more of a matte color, more than glossy. Then there's a controversial thought. You could either flick it or use your knuckles to tap it. And some people even slaps it. The purpose is to hear for the sound that is resonated inside the watermelon. Yes, that is some sort of science. Apparently, you want the sound to be a brighter resonance rather than a bass sounding watermelon. So you want tenor rather than bass. Because if it's a lower sounding watermelon, it may mean that it was hollow in the middle, and that's also called a hollow heart. Yes, it's terrible as it sounds. Please subscribe to help all the watermelon lovers to find this video. Although there are many, many ways to cut a watermelon due to its spherical shape, I will show you two. And you'll get to enjoy this fruit for the rest of your days. I like to rinse my fruits, and sometimes with soap. First, you cut it in half for the big reveal. It's always the most intense moment because that is when you will find out whether you've made the right decision. This one turned out pretty good. Cut the other end of the sphere off and then lay it flat. This method will consist of cutting the watermelon into bite-sized cubes. You want to remove all the rind, including the white part, and the red part we'll call it the flesh. The white part of the watermelon is edible. There are recipes out there if you're curious or ambitious. I prefer even removing a little bit of the flesh because when you eat too close to the white part, it does taste bland. And then I cut horizontal slices first, and then all the vertical. This is also purely based on how big of a bite size you would like. I love extremely small bites, so this is how I cut it, but you could definitely do larger chunks. Next technique is a little bit faster. You will keep the rind on. First, you cut the watermelon in half again. So this is a quarter of the sphere. And then you take one quarter and you cut it into slices now. I find this is a perfect portion for park and picnics. The next method is similar, but you cut them into even smaller pieces. So that might be more appropriate for adults who do like smaller sizes or for our children.
Full disclosure, I have had experience picking the wrong one. It's like 90% skills and 10% luck. So I wish you the best of luck this watermelon season. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. And until next time, bye everyone.